Hi everyone, I am back with another video. Today I'm going to be talking about what I did as an undergrad at University of California Riverside to get accepted to medical schools. I want to provide a disclaimer that the medical school application process is so unpredictable. You know, what goes into your application is your letters of rec, your interview, your personal statement, how you write about your activities, your grades, and your life history and your background and things like that. So they really look at you holistically. They want a picture of who you are as an applicant, who you are as an individual, what values you have, and all of that contributes to if they admit you to the medical school or not. So I'm going to give you insight into what I did, but by no means should you expect to, you know, copy everything I did and expect a guaranteed acceptance, because that's simply not the case. But I will be going into answering questions, and I have some notes on my phone here. So the first thing, what major I was. I was a biology major, but my tip is to choose any major that you like. I think most pre-meds go into college being a biology major, but in reality, you can be any major that you want. You can be a Spanish major, a film major, a medias major. As long as you fulfill the required courses for medical schools, you should be fine and can apply. The second tip I have is to focus on your grades and your MCAT. So statistics are important, they are not everything, but it certainly will not hurt you to get good grades and a good MCAT score. Personally, I had a 4.0 GPA and I scored within the 98th percentile of the MCAT. So statistically speaking, I was pretty strong on paper, but again, that is like one small aspect of your entire application. Medical schools understand that people go through things in college. You may have family circumstances, health issues, you know, outside factors that are affecting your career in terms of grades, or, you know, maybe affecting your studying for your MCAT. Whatever it may be, schools will give you an opportunity to explain that on the actual application. And I don't want people to think that you need a 4.0 GPA to get accepted, because that's simply not true. Just, of course, put your best foot forward, do your best in your classes, but it shouldn't take over your entire life. The next tip that I have is to get involved during your first year and have fun. As a freshman in college, you will have a lot of freedom, you will have a lot of time, and I would say it's best to take advantage of your free time, because you're probably never going to have that much free time for the next like 3 years of your college experience. Explore by joining different clubs, taking classes to explore your interests, you know, getting outside of your comfort zone and making friends. It's important because you can join a bunch of different things as a freshman, figure out the things that you really, really like, and then stay with those few things that you like for the rest of your college career. And I'll give you some examples that I did. So in my first year, I joined two different community service organizations that were like volunteer based, and I ended up really liking one more than the other because it worked with my schedule more, I related to the mission more. So I joined that one and I stuck with that for the rest of my college experience. I joined a psychology lab in my first year, realized it wasn't the best fit for me, and I ended up joining a different lab my second year and I stayed with that lab instead. I joined a lot of social clubs my first year, and then I just ended up dropping them if I didn't really like them later on. But your first year is the perfect opportunity to explore and try out different things. That is, when you find things that you like, stick with it. It's important to show quality over quantity. So when you join organizations, it's better to join maybe four things that you are super passionate about, you stick with for a long period of time, and you make meaningful changes in it. That is so much better than joining 30 different things and not being fully present in any of those organizations. When I interviewed at Harvard Medical School, they specifically told us in our interview that we were chosen because we showed a sustained interest in something over a long period of time. So that just means that it's better to show commitment to something, to show true passion. For instance, I think what helped me on my application was I joined the Recreation Governing Board at UCR in my freshman year, and it's a board that overlooks the gym and recreational facilities. And I joined it because I genuinely liked going to the gym. I my freshman year, I woke up at like 5 a.m. every day. Every day, I went to the gym, I was in class by 9, and I was really consistent with it, and that's simply because I like to work out, and two, the facilities at UCR are amazing. The gym is so, so pretty. So I definitely recommend it to anybody going to UCR. But I stayed with that organization, that board, for the next like 3 years. So I was in it all 4 years of college. If you find things you like, stick with it. Try to get leadership positions or make real changes in it. And by doing so also, you'll develop good relationships with faculty advisors or your boss if it's an employment position, and hopefully they can write you substantial letters of rec in the future. I joined Medical Scholars Program in my first year, which was a pipeline program with the UCR School of Medicine. And I became a math tutor in that organization, and I also became student leader coordinator in my senior year. And I also became an RA my second year, a resident advisor. And as an RA, I learned a lot about diversity, I learned a lot about leadership, conflict resolution, things like that. And I became an RA the following year and the year after that. So I was an RA in total for 3 years. And along with that, my next tip is to keep a journal of the things that you learn. And I'm talking about activities. So eventually when you apply for medical school, you will have to write about all of your activities, what you did, the takeaways from it, how it was meaningful, things like that. And so if you keep a journal of what you learned, how you felt after maybe a specific experience you had, you know, volunteering, or what you saw that day that was really cool during shadowing, you know, that will help you out a lot because you'll remember it when you start to write about it. The next thing is to explore the field of medicine with shadowing, volunteering, any type of clinical experience. I shadowed a family medicine physician at a community health clinic nearby. I also volunteered at that same community health clinic, but some people I know became EMTs. Some people volunteered at the Riverside Free Clinic on associated with the campus. Some people volunteered at the nearby hospital with this program called Cope Health Scholars. There's so many ways to gain clinical experience. I think one thing unique to me and something I would, you know, wanna put out there, I'm really interested in sexual health and health education, promotion about that. And so I found a way to promote women's health on campus. With anything that you do, if you're passionate about it, you'll find ways to get involved. Tip I have is to be you and be authentic. There are so many ways to get to medical school, and one student's journey is so different than another's. Some people take years off after college to, you know, really get their application together. Some people do a post-bac program, or they apply for a master's, or some people even, you know, don't realize that they want to be a physician until 10 years into their established careers, and then they decide to apply to medical school. Some people focus on raising a family, and they are mothers or fathers with kids, and then they apply to medical school, and one way is not more correct or more right than the other. Every way is unique to you, and you just need to find what works again for you. In the end, if you focus on yourself, you do the best that you can, you ask for help when you need it, you'll be fine. But again, I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, please just comment them down below, and I will definitely make more videos. So I hope you liked it. Bye.